This entire video was shot not only on one, not two, but four different iOS devices. I'm combining iPhones and iPads using Apple's new Final Cut Cam app. The Final Cut Cam app was just launched along with Final Cut Pro for iPad 2 and an updated Final Cut for Mac, and I am recording this entire video and editing it all on iPad. Spoiler, I did try editing on the iPad, but I just couldn't do it. I'll explain why in a minute. Right now, you can actually see I have four different camera angles running right now. This is on the 11-inch M4 iPad Pro. These two angles are actually iPads with Final Cut Cam. It works both on iPad and iPhone. This is the local iPad device. The front-facing camera is actually recording upwards. And then right here, you'll see I have my iPhone 15 Pro, and that's recording in ProRes video directly to an external SSD, and I get the full multi-view right here on my iPad. Not only that, but you get a ton of controls like frame rate, resolution for all the devices, and you can manage all the cameras, preview, focus, and more right from the Final Cut app. Once you update to Final Cut Pro for iPad 2, which it is a $5 a month or $50 a year subscription, and once you create a new project, you can choose to record in multicam mode. Then, if you have iOS devices logged into the same Apple ID, you can actually automatically tap them and connect them directly to the iPad. And if you have something on a different Apple ID, like a friend or family's iPhone or iPad, which I did as well, you get a four-digit pairing code, and you can add those devices to the multicam as well. You can have up to four camera angles, which is what I have right here. You can use the front-facing or back cameras. You can record in ProRes, log if you have a 15 Pro, and it's even recording the audio for every device. So you could have a microphone connected to these different devices, a USB mic connected to the iPhone, a different microphone connected to your iPad, and each camera angle is going to record that particular device. Right now, I have each device just recording from its built-in microphone. Once you pair all those devices to the Final Cut on iPad app, then you can go in and start changing all the settings. I set my iPhone 15 Pro to record ProRes video at 4K 30, and once I plugged in my external SSD, which is this OWC flash drive, it's my favorite flash drive, I've talked about it a ton of times, but I'll put a link to it in the video description because it records flawlessly that ProRes video and it looks just like a flash drive, but it's actually much more powerful than that. But it just makes it really easy to plug it in the iPhone and start recording. Now I did struggle to get an additional iPhone to connect here, and that's why I actually used the local iPad camera, which you can still do. This is actually recording the front-facing camera off this iPad. Also, for every camera angle, you can actually see the battery level for each device. So you'll see I have my two iPads, they're actually charging. This is the battery of the iPad right here, and the battery of my iPhone 15 Pro. You'll also see how much time you have left to record for each angle. If you wanted to preview the audio for any of these angles, you could actually tap the little speaker icon, and then you'll be monitoring the audio. Ideally, you would plug in headphones to the iPad device, could be AirPods as well, and then you'll start hearing the audio just from that camera angle. This would be great if you were doing like an interview style and you want to be able to hear the microphone of each individual guest. Maybe they have lapels. Well, you can do that all right here. Now, when I zoom into a camera angle, let's say my A-roll, my iPhone right here, you get the audio meters down here, how long it's been recording. Focus, you can go into manual mode if you want, and then I can actually rack the focus here from the iPad, and it's adjusting the iPhone focus. Then I can switch it back into autofocus, and I snap back into focus. You can also choose the zoom level. I'm actually at 1.5x right now on that main camera lens. You can adjust the exposure if you would like, or set that to auto, and you can even adjust the white balance with the slider here. And again, I'm doing this all wirelessly. This is actually controlling the iPhone device from the iPad. You can also tap the three dots down here, get a little more information, and you see this is angle one, my iPhone 15 Pro Max, and if I want to jump to a different camera angle, tells me the device name here. I can jump to my iPad mini, which is right here to my left, and this is the angle there. Tap the three dots again, I can switch angles, and now I'm on an iPad Pro that's on a different Apple ID, also connected right here. I can go to the local camera. This is the built-in iPad camera that's facing upwards, and I can shrink the view and go back into my multi-view setting. And what's wild is, as this is recording, it's actually streaming the video from all those devices to my iPad, and it's getting a pretty good quality, but less than the local recording version of the video right here, so I can start editing it right away. Then, once I stop recording, it will start transferring those high-resolution video files directly local to this iPad, and then it will automatically replace with the higher-quality files. This way, I can start editing right away, but I'm not going to sacrifice any quality in the end because I can just wait for those files to transfer, and then it will reference those better quality video files. I'm curious what it's going to do with the USB-C drive that has the ProRes video, But we'll find out in a few moments because I'm actually going to edit this entire video on my M4 iPad Pro as well. Yeah, just again, that didn't happen. I'll explain later. Haven't edited a video on there in a while, but we'll see how it goes. So I'm actually going to hit stop here and let's see what happens. So it looks like it's still recording on that ProRes device because it's going to that external SSD. So I'm going to hit stop now on my iPhone 15 Pro Max. All right, now that everything's done, it seems like there's one multicam clip for this entire recording. You can see before you start recording, you can adjust the project. Like I have 4K, 30 frames per second right now. I'm in SDR, not doing HDR. And you can toggle Apple ProRes on for all the cameras, or I just had this on for my iPhone 15 Pro Max, but disabled for the rest of the iPads. You can also toggle on any device can start the recording. So if I would have pressed it on my iPad, it would have started the recording for everyone. And you can toggle on and off those camera indicators like recording time left and that battery level. You can also just choose to have it when low for battery level or when low for the storage of what's being recorded. So I'm gonna hit done and you'll see it comes this pop-up where I can transfer those large video files from all the devices directly to this iPad now or transfer it later. Let's transfer it now. Maybe it'll give me a progress bar. And here we go. This is the progress of that multicam clip. You can see it's going pretty fast right now. 5 gigabytes total has to transfer. And we're almost halfway there. You can actually see on each device, there's another progress bar of how much of the media has transferred. So now that all the files have transferred, I'm going to tap and hold on the multicam clip here in the browser. I'm going to go to edit angles because I want to see a little more information on each clip. If I tap my iPhone 15 Pro Max, I can actually get a little more info here. And you'll see this is actually an HEVC recording of that video. So it seems like if I want to get the ProRes video for that angle, I'm actually going to have to connect my SSD directly to the iPad and transfer that data in. Honestly, this is probably going to look great. And now I'm going to just edit the rest of this right here on iPad. So here's the deal. I really had the full intention of editing this entire project on iPad, but I did record my audio separately on my Mac using my main setup. And I was not able to add another angle to the multicam clip on iPad. So I couldn't add my voiceover track. I did try deleting one of the tracks that were already there and putting my voice track in, but then it didn't sync properly and I was just having a really tough time. I'm just very used to editing on the Mac and editing on the iPad, even though it's super powerful and the multicam clip is super cool, it's just not something I think I'm gonna be doing. Maybe when I travel, and I did edit my entire Apple Watch Ultra 2 video on that when we went hiking a few months ago, but I'm all in on Final Cut on Mac. Plus, I have my Motion VFX plugins and all that other good stuff. So I need to record an ending for the video. So I'm actually going to jump back in and create another multicam clip. You can do that even though I've already created the project and recorded one multicam clip. I can tap the camera icon here, go into the live multicam, and then just start a new recording right here. So let's do just that. I'm going to start recording. If you have any questions on the new Final Cut Cam app for iPhone and iPad or Final Cut for iPad 2, it's a lot of words, very tongue twistery. Leave comments below this video. I'd love to answer them there. Also, subscribe to the channel. I have new Shortcuts videos coming soon. My 8th Shortcuts Request video. Gonna be building a bunch more that you guys have asked for. So excited for that. Plus, iOS 18 betas. We're in that season right now. I did do a video about shortcuts you can use on your iOS 18 lock screen because you can replace the flashlight and camera buttons now. So you can check out that video right up here. And I give you a little sneak peek at some of the new actions in Shortcuts for iOS 18. And if you want to learn more about my entire process, especially when I'm covering an Apple event and how I edit my A-roll video using AI tools to make it much faster, check out this video right up here where I go through a behind the scenes of my entire process. Thanks again for watching. I'll catch you next time.